For I will not hear the prayer. I will turn my face away from thee. They shall cry and entreat, and I will not hear. For I have turned my face from them. We all know when living an evil life that hell is what awaits, and that is why we are anxious. And so no one can say that they don't believe in hell. They do. And the proof is their anxiety, and their worry, and their frustration, and their anger. A soul that is in a state of mortal sin is in close contact with hell. We are in an age that is hellish. Because we are in an age in which mortal sin is praised, and mortal sin is cherished, and mortal sin is lived. We are in an age that is a kind of hell. An angel once appearing to St. John Bosco showed him the boys inside of his school. Now, St. John Bosco was a saint. There was an ST in the front of his name. He ran a school of Catholic boys. There were no non-Catholics in his school. And it was in the good old days. It was in the 1800s. And the angel showed the soul of his good Catholic boys that this saint was in charge of, and he saw that the vast majority of them were in the state of mortal sin and were already in hell. In fact, he saw these boys burning in hell. And the angel said to the angel, "But I just talked to that boy a couple of hours ago, and I just spoke to that boy a couple of hours ago. Did he die?" The angel said to John Bosco, "He has been. His soul is right here in hell as he is in the state of mortal sin. And though he does not physically feel the pains that you see him experiencing, it is only the thin veil of life that keeps him from feeling that pain. If he passes to eternity now, he will experience the pain that you see. He is already in hell." Such are the words of the angel of John Bosco to St. John Bosco.
It is appointed, it is then certain that we are all condemned to death. We shall then all be in eternity, which will be for us an eternal day of delights or an eternal night of torments. There is no middle way. It is certain and of faith that one or the other lot will be ours. And in truth, with death present to them, the saints have despised all the pleasures of this world. St. Charles Borromeo kept always on his table a skull, that he might continually contemplate it. All the gains and riches of this world terminate in a dying gasp, a funeral, and a descent into the grave. The house you have built will be given up to others. The tomb will be the habitation of your body till the day of judgment, and from thence it will pass to heaven or hell, where the soul will already have preceded it. It is certain that we shall all die, but when is uncertain? Nothing is more certain than death, and nothing is more uncertain than the hour of death. Already is the year, the month, the day, the hour, the moment fixed in which you and I are to leave this world and to enter into eternity.